grazie a un collegamento live streaming con popolazioni native degli Stati Uniti, siamo in contatto con gli Stati Uniti. Questo grazie al collettivo Uncovering the Land, un collettivo che si chiama da un'America, che ora si presenteranno e presenteranno i loro progetti, chiacchiere e focus, proprio per comprendere il cuore della storia di coloro, dando la voce però a coloro che sono sempre stati istituti, le popolazioni sommerse, mentre vedremo appunto un'altra voce, un'altra possibilità di incontrare. Grazie quindi a Jay Goldman e Lucia Palmi. Vedere da chi ci sta guardando, non perché per le persone che sono collegate, per scusate, hanno le spalle, ma in fondo per voi è bene guardare la sua. So this is our second edition being here at the Cerro de los Verdes. For our third edition, we will be coming back throughout the year, and we hope to see more audiences and to see
them again, see familiar friends and faces. So Lucia and I began this project because we both felt that our educational system had distorted historical facts about Christopher Columbus.
Dunque Lucia e io abbiamo cominciato questo progetto perché entrambi pensiamo che il sistema educativo abbia distorto i fatti riguardanti questo periodo storico.
And so we came together to join forces.
Dunque abbiamo lavorato insieme condividendo le nostre forze.
And realized that the importance of acknowledging the system that had been distorted by creating a digital platform collective to build a bridge for mutual understanding.
E abbiamo compreso l'importanza di riconoscere i fatti storici e abbiamo creato questa piattaforma online che ha proprio questo scopo.
And that mutual understanding is to build a bridge between the Italian community members of Genova and the indigenous peoples of the Americas.
E questa comprensione così reciproca è volta a creare un ponte fra la popolazione italiana di Genova e invece la popolazione indigena.
And we want to use this rare opportunity to do that, so we have this window of opportunity to bring the voices of my indigenous brothers and sisters and cousins, to give voice and share that space so that we can begin to understand each other.
Diamo il benvenuto a Cacique Jorge, il capo tribù di Taino, e a Veike Gipsy, che è il principale sciamano della tribù.
Ok, so let's welcome today Cacique Jorge, which is
And also we'll go into the opening and then following that the questions.
Perfetto, allora vi lasceremo il tempo di fare voi una piccola una vostra introduzione e poi saranno tutte le domande.
Whenever you're ready.
So everyone, buonasera. Italia de Cuba. And we are going to do an opening lesson, and we share this with you today, and we're very thankful to be here.
Where are you from? Just a mere footnote.
I can't understand why it's important to keep a day such as Columbus Day, right? It is a celebration of, like I said, somebody who committed rape, murder, land appropriation, and all things. Well, so it doesn't make sense to me if a birthday like that is celebrated and we don't celebrate it. Any of the historical figures that are just as bad or symptoms, maybe, but Columbus is concerned there. Hey, this doesn't make any sense to me, but some people want to hold on to it. I do think that that is more perspective. I think that celebrate Columbus Day never meet with the Trumpets. Understand exactly how what that was. He was a person who was for fame and glory, and he expected people, you know. And when he couldn't bring back the goal, promised between the peace just come on, he was human students. These were the Taino people. When you read Bartolomeo Casas and he comes, that he participated in, then you understand really different significance. So I think it's interesting to see that they actually understand what is the question of Columbus Day, and also why should we celebrate?
Real quick, I don't mean to interrupt, but
yes.
Wait, we have a. We have a translator who needs to translate your dialogue. So let's if you can just pause every now and then.
Okay.
Okay.
Penso che
io
non capisco perché continuare a celebrare a festeggiare. Non capisco perché continuare a festeggiare un giorno che in realtà è proprio celebrare persona che ha commesso crimini quali genocidio, stupro, e questa cosa non ha assolutamente senso per me, perché appunto la gente voglia continuare a festeggiare questa giornata.
Okay, actually we're going to go into the last question because we're running short on time.
Andremo adesso all'ultima domanda perché abbiamo poco tempo purtroppo.
So that is, what does the educational system write about Christopher Columbus, and how can we join an alliance with the Italians in Genoa to stand up and say, stop dividing us and tell us the truth?
Quindi la domanda è, com'è che il sistema educativo in Italia e in Europa rappresenta il periodo storico appunto riguardante Colombo, e come possiamo creare un'alleanza con gli italiani qui a Genova affinché i fatti storici non vengano più distorti?
I believe that one of the qualities of true friendship is to understand and to be understood.
E che sia soprattutto essere capire ed essere anche essere capiti.
So I think that this dialogue, mutual exploration of history, of the particular history.
E dunque ritengo che una reciproca, una esplorazione della storia.
I think that could help us both understand whether there is a need or not such a hot thing.
Posso aiutare a comprendere se vi è o meno il bisogno.
And perhaps we can celebrate our futures rather than simply was obviously a murder.
E forse potremmo festeggiare le popolazioni indigene invece di Colombo.
Okay, thank you.
Va bene, grazie.
I've got something to add.
Sure.
Qualcosa da aggiungere?
I believe
this kind of opportunity to communicate with each other and see each other is a very important thing. I also believe it's very important because Native people themselves are often innocent, and people are not even aware we are and well, it's not a time. So having the opportunity together and to have a discussion is the boost to them.
We skipped a couple words, it was a little distorted, so we'll try our best. Sorry, there's not much time to talk to you, but we really want to thank you because your words are really important, and it was an honor and a privilege to have you here somehow in general.
Thank you. credo si tratti di un momento storico, grazie alla vostra testimonianza di oggi. Ebbene, mi è piaciuto molto osservarvi durante questi 20 minuti e non potevo lasciarvi andare senza sprecare alcune parole riguardanti appunto questo momento storico per Genova, che è un posto dove Colombo comunque ha lasciato certamente delle tracce, così ha fatto anche il capitano De Albertis, che ha fondato questo castello, costruito questo castello nel 1892, che non è una data casuale. È come Colombo anche qui si è recato a San Salvador, e in questo museo ci sono anche tracce di Colombo relative per esempio alle caravelle, ad alcuni strumenti nautici, eccetera. Quindi questo ci fa capire che è molto importante riconoscere nella storia le due voci, quindi ovviamente riconoscere la vostra esistenza ma anche le tracce di Colombo. E questo è un museo appunto delle culture che riconosce più voci, vuole essere anche un luogo di una cosiddetta prospettiva polifonica. Quindi vi ringrazio moltissimo.
So before I make this introduction, I think about the last 500 years of our resiliency of indigenous people, that we're still here, we still exist. That after 500 years that we can still stay here and exist, our historical trauma. And with that in mind, I'm going to jump back here to the present and introduce Mark Charles, who is the first Diné from the Navajo Nation who is independently running for the United States presidency.
Speech, un suo discorso che ha tenuto durante la prima marcia di tutte le popolazioni indigene che si è tenuta a gennaio a Washington, nella quale abbiamo avuto la possibilità di partecipare. Non lo so di sicuro.
So the speech you're gonna watch, is about the first march where all Native tribes took part in, and it was held in January in Washington, and we had a chance to do that.
I want to thank everybody for coming out this morning, and I want to take the few minutes that I have to talk a little bit about history and mythology. One of the challenges we face as indigenous peoples living in colonized nations is that our history is not taught, our oral history is not taught, and our colonizers do not know how to teach their own history. Let me explain this and help you understand this. A few years ago, I was walking on a Monday morning on a day that we celebrate as Indigenous People Day in October, but our colonizer celebrates Columbus Day. And I was walking by the statue of Christopher Columbus, and there was a group of people there for a ceremony. And I walked up to the front of the crowd before they started speaking, and I said to them something we know that they were not aware of. I said, "You cannot discover lands already inhabited." I wasn't sure if they heard me, so I said a little bit louder. I said, "You cannot discover lands that are already inhabited." That's known as stealing, conquering, colonizing. The fact that you call it discovery reveals your implicit racial bias, which is that indigenous peoples, people of color, are not fully human. This is one of the challenges, and it's come from what's called the doctrine of discovery. The doctrine of discovery is essentially a series of papal bulls, or edicts of the Catholic Church, written in the 1400s. They essentially have a church in Europe telling the nations of Europe, wherever you go, whatever lands you find not ruled by white European Christian rulers, those people are less than human, and their land is yours for the taking. This is literally the doctrine that led European nations colonize Africa and enslave the people, as well as that Columbus, who was lost at sea, landed in this new world already inhabited by millions and claimed to have discovered it. See, they don't know how to teach their history or even teach the right thing. We need to teach our colonizers their own history. We need to help them understand the oral history of these lands. And as our elder, George Erasmus, from the tribes up north says, that where common memory is lacking, where you do not have a unified memory, you cannot have community. If you want to build community, he says, you need to start by creating a common memory. And this is the challenge I'm going to lay out to all of us. We need to help our colonizers understand the oral history of this land and their own genocidal ethnic cleansing history of this land, so that we, a people, all the people, can create a common memory and can have better life, better community, and walk in beauty with one another. I shout out my relatives, thank you for coming today.
So, una cosa che mi piace, perché mi ha insegnato il genio, il loro modo di salutare le persone, e dicono walk in beauty, camminiamo nella bellezza, no? E quindi abbiamo la possibilità
One thing I really liked that I was told is the walking beauty, so it's a way to say goodbye. And now we have the chance to follow this expression and take it as our direction, and I hope you will do the same. Thank you.
Grazie.
Yeah.